Oh, this is the drawer where I store my bronzers, highlighters, blushes, and powders. And I also have my highlighting palettes and my contouring palettes in here as well. This is on the right side of my vanity, and this is the top drawer. This is probably my favorite drawer aside from my eyeshadow palette drawer. And yeah, so it's just jam-packed with a ton of stuff. So let's just start over here where the palettes are. Okay, so the first palette here is an Anastasia Glow Kit, and this is the Glow Kit in Ultimate Glow, and this has 6 shades in it. My favorites are White Sand and Snow. They're just the most creamy and the most buttery, so those are definitely my favorite. I really like this palette. My husband bought it for me for my birthday, so I'm definitely keeping it. I love the Anastasia Glow Kits. And then I have one more glow kit, and this is the That Glow Glow Kit. This holds some of my favorite highlighters of all time. I really love Bubbly. It's perfect for the spring. I've been wearing it tons lately. And then I really love putting Dripping in Gold on my cheekbones and putting Sunburst right in the middle. It just makes for such a beautiful glow. These highlighters are so creamy and so pigmented. I absolutely love them, so I'm definitely keeping this. Okay, so next palette is this Tarte Pro Glow palette, and this one is pretty new to me. I've only had it for probably a month now, but it is just such a gorgeous palette. I love all of these. It smells like chocolate. My favorite is this Sculpt shade. It's perfect for contouring. Also, the highlighter Stunner is one of my favorites. It's the most pigmented, I feel like, in this palette. And also the shade Lit is such a pretty gold shade, so I love this palette. I'm definitely keeping it. So the next highlighter palette I have is the Becca and Jaclyn Hill palette in Champagne Glow, and I really love this palette because it has Champagne Pop in it, and this highlighter is just amazing for every skin tone. It has a huge dent in it. I don't know if you can see, but it's such a pretty peachy goldy, just perfect shade. It's actually really hard to explain. I don't really touch this blush topper, but I really do love this shade Pearl. I put it on top of Champagne Pop sometimes when I want a really intense glow, so I'm gonna keep this palette. And then the last highlighter palette I have is this Tarte one, and this is the highlighting palette in Skin Twinkle, and these shades are very light. They make for a really pretty subtle glow. And then this middle shade is just a very sheer powder, which is actually a really nice powder. It's super fine milled, and this was supposed to be a limited edition palette, I'm pretty sure, and I saw it go out of stock, but then I saw it go back in, and then I saw it on sale, so I'm not sure if you can still get this palette. I hardly use this palette, but I think it's really pretty when I want just a subtle glow, so I think I'm gonna put this in the maybe pile. So next I have this Vintage by Jessica, and I cannot pronounce her last name, so I'm not gonna butcher it, but this has 2 highlighter shades, and they're in the shades Rose Quartz and Chocolate Diamond. These shades are on the darker side, though I would actually use them more for eyeshadow, so I think I'm gonna give this one away. But the highlighters are super smooth and really pigmented. They're actually really nice shades, but I am going to give this one away. So this is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Illuminating Palette, and this was super cheap. I think this whole thing was only about $4, and it has 4 different strips of shades in here. I think this palette is really pretty. The shades formula are really good for the price that they are. They're slightly on the glittery side, I want to say. This pink shade isn't too bad for glitter, but I think this golden shade has lots of glitter in it. This highlighting palette is really smooth and really nice, but I think I am going to pass this one on just because I don't reach for it as much. So this next highlighter is the Physicians Formula highlighter in the shade Beige Pearl. I thought I was really going to love this highlighter because, first of all, the shade is super pretty, and when you swatch it, it just looks so beautiful and so smooth. But when I put this on my face, I don't know where or how the glitter chunks came from, but on my face it just looks so glittery and chunky. But the highlight shade actually looks really smooth when you swatch it, so I only used it one time, so I think I'm gonna keep it just to keep trying it out because I have seen another YouTuber use this one. That's why I bought it, but it looks super beautiful on her, so I'm going to keep trying this out. I only gave it one go. So the next highlighter is another Vintage highlighter, and this one is in the shade Rose Gold. And when I first opened this, I got this in my BoxyCharm. I actually thought it was a blush because the shade really looks like a blush, but it is actually a highlighter. It's extremely pink for a highlighter, but it has some gold reflex in it, kind of like rose gold, like what the name is basically. But yeah, the highlighter is really pretty. I don't think I'm gonna use it just because it's not really my kind of shade, so I am going to give this one away. So the next one I have here is the Physicians Formula Shimmer Strip, and this one is in the shade Miami Strip, and I absolutely love this one. I'm definitely keeping it. The first 2 shades mixed are my absolute favorite, and I really love mixing all 3. When I was around 11 years old, I used to use this as eyeshadow, and now I use it as a highlighter, so I am going to keep this. The next highlighter I have is the NARS highlighter in the shade Albatross, and this is such a throwback highlighter. I'm pretty sure this is the first highlighter I ever bought before I even knew that highlighting was a thing. I just saw a picture of it on Pinterest and I thought it looked so pretty, so I wanted to buy it, and I'm pretty sure it's pretty chalky now because I got it a while ago, but I think I'm gonna keep it just because of memories. I actually really do love this highlighter. It's a bit on the yellowy side, but once it's on your face, it looks really nice. So I am going to keep this. Okay, next highlighter I have is this Essence Pure Nude Highlighter. And this is just extremely cheap and it's a beautiful highlight shade. It's so smooth and buttery and it's just a really pretty golden highlight. It comes off a lot darker when you swatch it, but once it goes on your face, it's just a really nice, subtle highlight. So I am going to keep this one. It's perfect for drugstore looks and everything. It's super affordable and I really love it. The next one I have is this little Josie Maran Argan Enlightenment Illuminizing Veil is what it says. And I actually don't see a shade name on here or anything like that. So maybe that's just what it's called. But yeah, this one's just so cute. It has a little quote on the mirror and everything. And this one is a really pretty subtle highlight. I really love this highlight. I am going to keep it. So the next highlight I have is this one from Becca. And this one is in the shade Opal. This is the first Becca highlight I own. And it's just a super pretty golden highlight. This one has a big dent in it. I don't know if you can see. This highlight I was wearing nonstop for like 4 months straight. I couldn't get away from it. And so I finally forced myself to buy new highlights. So I actually didn't realize that I don't have many highlights until I just started going through them now. So I am going to keep this one. I really love it. So I just have two more little sample highlighters. This one is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in the shade Opal as well. When I want a really intense highlight, I like to put this liquid one on my cheekbones and temples and then put the Opal pressed powder on top. And it makes for a really intense highlight. I really love it. So I am definitely going to keep this one. And then the next little one I have is this Benefit What's Up highlighter. And this actually had a lot of product. I actually got it down to just a little nub, but for it being just a little sample size, it has tons of product. And I used to use this nonstop in the summertime. It's a really pretty golden highlight. So I am going to keep this one. When I use it up, I'm definitely buying a full size one. I really love this. These are actually the last two. I forgot about these ones. These were in another drawer, but this one is the Josie Maran Illuminizing Wand. This is just a stick form and it is a really pretty golden highlight. I really like this one, so I'm gonna keep it. And then this little one I got as a deluxe sample at Sephora, and this is the Cover FX Custom Enhancer Drops. And I was really happy they had this on for a deluxe sample because I couldn't see myself buying a full size one, just because I don't think that I would use that much liquid highlighter, because a little goes a super long way. So this one is in the shade Moonlight and it's extremely intense. I tried it on once when I was just hanging out at home, and I haven't put it on to go out yet just because it's super intense and really beaming. So I might wear this in the summertime, so I'll keep it for now. So that looks like it's it for highlighters. I decided I'll keep this Tarte palette just because I realized I don't actually own that many highlighters. And now we'll just move on to powders really quick. So the first one I have is this RCMA No Color Powder. So I just got this recently and I'm already down to here. I just got this off of Amazon, and this is the only powder that has really helped with any creasing that I get from my concealer. Obviously you get creases regardless when you wear concealer, but this powder has helped me the most with that. So I am definitely going to keep this. It's so perfect and it's really nice for cleaning up the contour. Next powder I have is this e.l.f. Translucent Powder. And when I saw the picture, I thought that this would be a peachy powder and this would be a white powder, but this actually ended up being a sponge. So that kind of threw me for a loop because I was planning on just using the white powder, but it ended up being a sponge. I didn't return it because it's only $4. So I am going to pass this one along just because I don't think this peachy shade would really match me that well. So the next powder I have is this L'Oreal True Match Powder. And this is in the shade N1. It doesn't really match my skin tone perfectly, but I really like it for setting my eyes when I put concealer on to prime them. So I am going to keep this one. It's a really nice smooth powder and doesn't feel drying whatsoever. So I might go and try and find my exact shade. But for now, this is really nice for setting my primer. Next, I have two Rimmel Stay Mattes. And this one is the shade 44 Sandstorm. And I used to use this one all the time just to set all over my face. I have dry skin and it doesn't dry my skin out whatsoever. I used to wear it to work because I would work 12-hour shifts and I would sometimes be sweating on my face. So I definitely wanted to wear a powder and this one really helped me a lot. And recently I had no idea that they had this shade in the shade Transparent. This one's just perfect for setting my concealer when I prime my eyes. And also when I have a really dewy foundation, I really like to put this one over top and I feel like it really balances it out. So yeah, I really love these powders and I am going to keep them. The next powder I have is this Ofra Pressed Powder. And this is an oil control powder, but I feel like it doesn't dry my skin out whatsoever. It actually feels extremely smooth. And I totally forgot about this powder. I think I will keep it just to try it out again, just because I don't really remember how well I liked it. So I'm just going to try it out a bit and see if I want to keep it. And then I think this is the last powder I have, and this is the Maybelline Fit Me Powder, and this is in the shade 120. I use this powder only a couple times, but I really like it. It's super smooth. I actually meant to get the Hydrate in Smooth one, but I accidentally got the Matte in Poreless one. But regardless, it's not that drying anyways, but I still want to get the Hydrate in Smooth one. But for now, I will keep this one because I do really like it. Okay, so I feel like that wasn't one of my huge collections out of of all my makeup. So I only got rid of just 4 things. So I'm getting rid of the e.l.f. translucent powder and the 2 vintage highlighter palettes and then this Wet n Wild one. So that looks like it's all for highlighters and powders today. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave and like the video if you enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!